Hey, Rye. Brian Campbell, Homewood, Cookie Fix, coming at you with installment number 4 of Homegrown. Had a great visit today with Amy and Jason. And you guys are going to love the video. Love talking about the cook. Hang on one second. You guys are going to love the video. All these different kinds of cookies here. These are delicious.
Hey, Brian, we're ready for more of those cookies. We've got an order coming up.
Here they are, just like you asked.
Okay, awesome.
Brian, there should be a dozen cookies on this tray. There's only about 6.
I don't know what you're talking about.
Did you eat them all?
You said they were complimentary.
Brian, where are you going?
Amy, thanks for having us.
You're welcome.
We appreciate it. So, Cookie Fix Homewood, tell me a little bit about what got you in the cookie business.
Well, I started baking when I was very little, about 8 or 9 years old. My mom was a great cook, but she didn't bake a lot. And I have such a sweet tooth that I could kind of, I started filling in the gap at about 9 years old. And I just started making desserts when I was little. And then in high school, made more, in college, made more desserts. As a newlywed, I quickly became the dessert queen. And I don't always know it's for dinner, but I know it's for dessert.
That's right.
I don't really care about the meat and potatoes, but give me dessert.
Yeah, the dessert's the most important part of dinner, right?
Exactly.
Yeah, my kids will say anyway.
Right. And so then as a young mom, I did not have a half a day to make desserts. But kids love cookies, and all my kids' friends love cookies. And so I just started making cookies, and I was making so many that we couldn't eat them all. Or we would eat the whole batch in a day. Literally, and I decided, you know, there's got to be another way. So I started freezing the dough balls, and then I didn't have to make cookies every day. I would just reach in the freezer, and I just had an obsession. I just kept trying more and more recipes and just perfecting and tweaking recipes. When our second went to college is when I knew it was time to start getting serious about it. We love Homewood's, just thrilled with this location. We had some good friends that are businessmen that kind of helped me and advised me on location. And as soon as we walked into this spot, we knew, okay, this is it.
Yeah. Speaking of these cookies, do you guys have a bestseller or a crowd favorite, if you will?
Chocolate chip is always
good. Is it right over here?
It is.
Can we walk over here and look? Are you guys good with that?
Right here, third down from the right.
All right.
It's not my favorite cookie.
It's not your favorite?
I like a lot going on. Like today,
what's your favorite?
Salted dark chocolate caramel.
Okay.
Peanut butter salted caramel pretzel.
Okay.
Homewood Heath.
Oh, yeah.
It's rough choosing a favorite.
It really is.
I really have about 5 favorites today.
Yeah.
It is.
Yeah.
It's like picking a favorite child. You just can't do it.
Can't do it. At least not in front of them,
right?
So, yeah.
But really what sets them apart is they're crispy on the outside, gooey on the inside.
Okay.
We underbake just a little bit, because that's the way we want them. We like a tall cookie that you're really going to get a mouthful of loaded ingredients. It's not just chocolate for a lot of them. It's toffee, it's caramel, it's espresso, it's cocoa, it's
everything good.
It's peanut butter chips. It's a whole lot of good stuff.
Yeah.
A lot of them come in and they have their favorite cookie. They know what they want. One guy just last week, white trash was taken off the menu. He and I both love white trash. And we've decided we're gonna start a campaign to bring back white trash. And he knows some people.
And the other thing is people just love to give cookies. They're giving themselves. And that's really our favorite part of being here, is we get to hear the most awesome stories. We have people come in who are buying them because their sister had a baby and they're going to the hospital, or their friend is trying out for something, or has an interview and they wanna say good luck, or they wanna say congratulations, or they wanna say, better luck next time.
Sure.
You know, cookies tell a story.
Yeah.
And people are sharing themselves when they're sharing cookies. Yeah. And that's really how it all got started, as I was sharing myself and loving on people and spreading smiles with
cookies. That's awesome.